Well, a long-awaited investigation into sexism and discrimination in Australia's music industry has revealed a widespread problem. The Raising Their Voices report found more than 50% of respondents have experienced some form of sexual harassment or sexual harm during their career. The report's authors described their findings as confronting but not unexpected. Well, Aussie musician Jaguar Jonze's allegations about her experiences in the music industry helped kickstart this whole conversation, and Jaguar joins us now. Jaguar, 55% of respondents say they've experienced some form of sexual harassment or harm in their music career, but only 3% said they lodged a formal report. From what you've seen, how difficult is it to come forward?
Well, when you've got an industry with a culture of silence like the music industry does and a perceived lack of accountability for perpetrators, it's extremely difficult to put that energy onto survivors when they don't have a safe space to speak up. So, yeah, I wasn't surprised to see that at all, but it was extremely saddening.
So you've heard 400 stories. Can you give us a bit of an example of the messages you're hearing?
Well, 400 stories was what came directly to me, but to make it clear, this report represents the voices of 1,600 people. So it definitely is something that we can't run away from the music industry or deny anymore. The stories are distressing, and I definitely encourage the music industry to read the report, but also to seek support and care over the coming weeks.
Do you think we know in public the full extent of what has gone on, what does go on?
No, definitely not, because even with telling my story to the project, we've had to dance around because of the defamation laws in our country. But I think a lot of people will hear whispers along the grapevine and understand the picture of what the music industry culture is like.
I haven't lived through what you have gone through, but I can only imagine that at times it must have felt an incredibly lonely space to be occupying, talking about this in public. I wonder what it does for you seeing these figures in print, seeing the data out there and being discussed publicly?
For me, it's a really hard day today. A lot of, you know, the trauma and the journey has come up for me today, but today it feels like I'm not alone in the journey anymore. It's not a singular voice, it's 1,600 voices, and the collective strength of all the survivors and people who participated in this review has allowed people to feel like they're being listened to.
Hopefully this is a day where we can look back and say this is where things started to change. What are your hopes going forward for the future generations of musicians?
I really hope that the industry leaders and people of influence come together with their power and their resources and implement the 17 recommendations that the report listed and start to begin a cultural shift of change and action in our Australian music industry. We should be so proud of our industry, and I really hope that it will also be a safe one for all the future artists and workers who come into it.
Jaguar, you've been such an amazing advocate. A lot of this does not happen without you. With that said, Bunny Mode is extraordinary. Congratulations. It is a powerful piece of work. You should be extremely proud of it.
Thank you so much. Thank you. I appreciate that.
And one day we'll get you back on and it'll just be music, Jaguar. That's what we're hoping for.
That's the dream.
That's when we know things have definitely moved ahead. Thanks so much for your time, Jaguar.
Thank you so much.